You might know Micromax as an Indian firm that used to make smartphones and still makes smartphones. However, what you might not know is the fact that a couple of years back, Micromax also started a new division which goes by the name of Micromax Energy Limited, and the company especially deals in the manufacturing and the sourcing of lithium-ion batteries. Today, I have with myself the country head of Micromax Energy Limited, Mr. Sunil Bhatnagar, who is going to tell us a little bit more about the company and what his general expectations are from the Indian lithium-ion market and where he sees in the long run going his company forward. Hi, sir.
Hi.
Can we start by knowing a bit about what was the basis of formation behind Micromax Energy Limited and what was the general idea behind formation of this company?
Yeah. See, now the market is changing very fast, and you see a lot of pollution issues are there, and a lot of mobility issues are there, and India is a net importer of the crude. So a lot of focus of government on electric vehicles. And similarly, if you see the electricity fund, then we are short of electricity in the rural area. So all these factors we were thinking, and Micromax then started this division for battery, or lithium batteries basically. So lithium is the latest evolving market for a green battery. Lithium is a green battery. There is no pollution in it basically. So it is a green battery, and it is a very good kind of battery, very fast charge and all that. So, seeing to the opportunities of pollution control and electric vehicles coming on the roads, especially the two-wheelers and three-wheelers, and rural electrification. So, these were the reasons that Micromax Energy Limited, this energy division was formed to support all this new ventures which are coming. And huge market is potential is there. So that is the reason this division is started.
Okay, wonderful, sir. So of course, I'm sure that a lot of other companies in India, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, but as far as my knowledge is concerned, a lot of other companies in India are also either already manufacturing lithium-ion batteries or of course in the process of starting to manufacture, a lot of big companies that we know out there. So if you have to differentiate Micromax Energy Limited as opposed to your other competitors and other companies generally in the market, what would you say are Micromax's core strengths that are going to differentiate your company from others?
Yeah. See, Micromax core strength is that because we are already an established player and Micromax is a big brand in the market. And when we are doing our mobile phones, there also we use the lithium technology. So we have grip on lithium technology for last 4 or 5 years basically, because lithium cells, this battery packs goes in the mobile also. Though they are small one, but the same thing you can explore it further here. So that is one thing. So that is one our strength, that we are already in the market available, and we have very good experience of last 4 or 5 years for the lithium. And I especially belong to battery line for last 26 years. So huge exposure is there for the battery division basically. Competition is not as such as on date. Lithium is very new vertical. So some people are coming, some are very new companies, they don't have any exposure as such, but they are trying out. And some projects are coming which will take maybe 2 years or 3 years to come. So Micromax plus point is that we have already started, and we have a battery assembly shop or manufacturing place basically in Bhiwadi and in Rudrapur. Where we make all these packs. So cells are imported basically. Presently, lithium cells are not made in India. So we also have plans to do that, but let the time come. Because presently, the market potential is not that much that you put a big company like that. It is a huge investment basically. So we are working on that. But our main strength is that we have a in-house BMS facility, which is known as battery management system. That we make ourselves in-house. So that is the biggest strength, because lithium battery is basically a composition of many cells. So when you put some cells in series and parallel, then they are controlled by a BMS. And BMS is the most important part for cell balancing and for the life of the battery pack and like that. So that is our main strength basically. And most of the people, they import BMS from China. But we do it in-house.
Okay, wonderful. So as you yourself right now just said that not a lot of companies are currently, you know, in this sphere, because this is a very developing one and not a lot of players are there in the market right now. So since you have decided to enter into this particular segment, so because, you know, of course, there's around the world, you can see that there's this huge push of going towards, you know, greener and cleaner source of energy. Like you just mentioned yourself that lithium is a green technology, right? So why do you think that this exactly is the right time to be investing in such green technologies? And why would you say that Micromax exactly has, you know, decided to do this, this green thing in itself?
See, basically what is happening, there are two, three areas where this technology is coming very fast.
Yes.
So one is your electric mobility, which is the, I think, very fast coming segment in India.
Okay.
And you see all these electric rickshaws, which were driven earlier by lead acid batteries.
Mm-hmm.
Now they are converting to lithium batteries, basically.
Okay.
So you have such a huge population of e-rickshaws,
mm-hmm.
and a lot more are coming.
Mm-hmm.
Similarly, if you go for e-auto, or you go for a e-two-wheeler. So you have very huge potential. All these things are coming, and these are driven on lithium batteries.
Okay.
Because of the advantage that, because lead acid battery is a very heavy battery and it takes a lot of time to charge, basically 8 to 10 hours to charge.
Mm-hmm.
Whereas lithium just gets charged in maybe 1 hour, 1.5 hour
mm-hmm.
maximum, and weight-wise it is just 1/3 of the lead acid.
Okay.
So it is very efficient battery, very long life battery,
mm-hmm.
and there is no maintenance required. Because the BMS will take care of everything. So that is one area which is very highly potential area. Another area is your villages. And you have a lot of community center in this rural areas.
Yes.
And banks are there, small banks are there, and like that, and schools are there. So all these, they don't have light. So that is a big issue, basically. So if you go through lithium storage and store the light through solar, then I think it is the best thing to do, because it is very cost effective, first thing.
Mm-hmm.
And solar and battery both are green.
Mm-hmm.
So you are doing a very good thing to avoid pollution of DG sets or some other diesel run devices or something.
Yes.
Like that. So that is another potential area.
Yeah.
Third potential area is your digital economy, which is now being coming very fast in India. Everything you see is now digital, basically.
Mm-hmm.
So all these digital things, they work on lithium batteries.
Yes.
Or POS machines.
Yes.
Or you talk of another ATMs or something. So everything is on now lithium.
Mm-hmm.
So this is very ripe time in India to come in this vertical,
mm-hmm.
lithium vertical.
Mm-hmm.
And accordingly, Micromax Energy, because we were already there in the mobiles and we have that kind of exposure and experience,
mm-hmm.
so we decided to start this thing.
Mm-hmm.
And we are working in all these verticals, whether it is electric mobility or it is solar electrification, rural electrification,
mm-hmm.
or it is point of sale or other digital means of this thing, equipments.
Okay.
We are doing all.
Okay. So Mr. Bhatnagar, I still remember that, you know, a few years back when this entire smartphone and mobile revolution was breaking out in India, you know, when everyone wanted a smartphone, I still remember, and most of my friends, you know, Micromax was that one company, being Indian, that, you know, sort of provided a mobile phone in each of our hands with the carbon series, with that, I don't remember exactly, but you had this series in particular, and I remember that...
We were doing a lot of changes at that time.
Yes.
We even launched a phone which were having a 30 days backup battery.
Yes. So I remember Micromax was behind, you know, that entire revolution, one of the strongest players back then, right? So of course you have always been that, you've always had that essence in yourself that you're an Indian company and you're working towards, you know, towards the Indian market, and now you are in this lithium-ion technology. And of course, you know, Prime Minister's tenure starting and this entire strengthening of the Make in India campaign. So how would you say is Micromax Energy Limited now, like, you know, the lithium technology and the lithium department entirely, how is that contributing towards the Make in India story?
See, this is a very good initiative by the government, because ultimately we would be very effective and we will be very cost effective, and we can save a lot of foreign exchange.
Yes.
If we do it Make in India.
Yes.
So Make in India is a very good thing which is going on as of now. And Micromax is firm believer of local manufacturing. We manufacture LED TVs also here, and we manufacture our mobile phones, and similarly we have so many appliance division where we manufacture few other things, and we have plants in Hyderabad, Rudhpur, Bhiwadi, and one, two more are coming. So Micromax is a firm believer of Make in India. Energy division, what we are doing, we have developed a battery pack for e-rickshaw.
Okay.
Which is now being approved by ICAT also.
Okay.
It is tested and passed there. And similarly, our other batteries for solar and other applications are also tested and passed by the relevant agencies.
Right.
So we are a firm believer that you develop in India, supply in India, and you know the exact needs on the Indian market.
Mm-hmm.
that what exactly they need, yes, basically. Yes. And there are so many government tenders for rural electrification and everything. And we supply our lithium batteries to all the states, basically, mm-hmm, which are driven by this programs of solar home lighting and solar street lighting and like that. Mm-hmm. So that is the biggest plus point of Make in India. You need not carry a huge inventory of imports. Mm-hmm. Just you have basic cells, and whatever requirement is there, you make a pack and supply. Mm-hmm. You make BMS, you make pack, and the local contribution is very good, yes, in that pack. So you know the market, because here, what is the problem in India? Because Indian temperatures are quite different. Yes. When you talk of China or when you talk of European countries, the temperatures are quite good, yes, cooler. Yes. But in India, it is the thermal management is very important.
Mm-hmm. And because robust system for that.
Yeah, robust system. Yes. So your BMS should be able to handle that kind of thermal thing. Mm-hmm. Because your ambient goes 45, 48 degree, mm-hmm, and when you discharge, then it can go even more than 50 also. Mm-hmm. So you should have that kind of thermal management. That is very important in any battery pack. Mm. So we have adapted all these conditions, Indian conditions, and we make in India.
Right. Okay. You know, one thing that you particularly said that really struck a chord with me was the fact that since you are an Indian company, born and brought up here, you know, living in this condition, so of course you know what exactly these conditions demand out of a company, right? So of course you also know the fact that energy in itself has been a topic in a country that is highly divisive, in the fact that we are sitting here right now in Gurgaon in your office, right? And of course your entire office has a different energy consumption and a different energy requirement. But you just go down a few lanes, and if you go to a rural place, of course the energy requirements in that very household are very different. So you know, we have this entire spectrum of energy requirements where you have people sitting in the Lutyens and then a person in the rural parts of the country. So how do you have, products to, you know, satisfy this entire spectrum of energy requirement? And if you, how are you planning to basically cater to, you know, this entire industry, starting from the right to the bottom?
Yeah. See, there are different segments, mm-hmm, and you have to basically divide the market.
Yes.
So there are some big metros like Delhi, Bombay, Bangalore, and mm-hmm, all this, Hyderabad, and they are the big metros. Mm-hmm. Where the consumption pattern is altogether different. There are medium towns also. Consumption pattern is different. There are villages, altogether different pattern. So what we have done, we have classified all these markets. Okay. And accordingly, we have developed a product. Okay. Like for storage, if you talk of storage for domestic use, then we have series in 12 volt, we have series in 24 volt, we have series in 48 volt also. No, depending on the backup time, it goes like that. So this requirement is very small, then we go for 12 volt series basically, because we know the backup required will be maybe 2 hours, 1.5 hours, something like that. But if requirement is more, you go for 24 volt system. If you want 8 hour backup or something, you go for 48 volt. So we have different ESS, basically these are known as energy storage solutions. So we have different ESS solution based on lithium technology with digital inverter, which is Micromax make again. So that we supply all over India. That is one segment.
Right.
But there are very specific segment. Like if you talk of nowadays rural electrification, mm-hmm, then you see these street lights, mm-hmm, high mast lights, mm-hmm, and you have small villages where you require a very small home light system. Mm-hmm. So for that there is a different system.
Yes.
So for that we have different package. Okay. So accordingly developed for that. Mm-hmm. When you come to e-rickshaw side, mm-hmm, it is generally a 48 volt system. Mm-hmm. So we have developed various kind of batteries,
right,
with different backups,
right,
for in 48 volt,
right,
system.
Right.
When you come to a bike, mm-hmm, it is a 72 volt system or a 60 volt system.
Mm-hmm.
So again, you have a different AH there.
Mm-hmm.
So ampere hour may vary, mm-hmm, depending on the city.
Mm-hmm.
But on the basis of application, mm-hmm, the voltages decide.
Mm-hmm.
On the basis of the motor they use, the voltages decide.
Mm-hmm.
And accordingly, we have developed all kind of products.
Okay.
We have products for two-wheeler, three-wheeler, four-wheeler,
okay,
for electrification, for household,
mm-hmm,
and for POS and other machines.
Okay. So, okay, so since you said that you have batteries for, you know, for automobiles, e-automobiles, and also for electrification inside within the house, so out of all these different segments, is there a particular segment that you're targeting more because you have more aspiration, expectation, mm-hmm, that, like the automobile sector, say, because it is expected,
yeah,
to grow by 2030. People,
yeah,
are saying everything will be automatic on the, or sorry, electrified on the road, right? So do you have a special expectation from any particular sector as of now?
Yeah. See, presently government has some programs, like one is your this thing, Sobhagya, this thing. Some scheme is there, Sobhagya, I think. I'm just forgetting the name.
The one which is going to fulfill all the rural electrification, right?
Rural electrification. Yes. So that is Sobhagya scheme is there. So under that, a lot of tenders are coming, right? So we are not participating in any tender because our forte is lithium batteries.
Yes.
So we supply to the participants, basically, who are there.
Okay.
So under that scheme, we are doing very good work, basically. Presently, a lot of work has come under that.
Okay.
Similarly, e-auto and e-rickshaw. Now again, government and the metro, they are focusing on last mile connectivity. So again, we are focusing on that, that how to develop that kind of product. So there are some areas which are developing very fast. Some areas are developing, but they have a good potential later. So we have all kind of products, and depending on the market requirement, because ours is a Make in India thing. So whatever demand is there, we can accordingly do shifting in our factory, that okay, this kind of product is required in this month or next month this product is required. So accordingly we book. So we have some basic inventories. Basically there are two technologies involved in lithium. One is your lithium iron phosphate, which is the technology which is quite safe and very long life batteries are there. And another is NMC, that is nickel manganese cobalt technology basically. So that is a different kind of application, and LFP, the iron phosphate technology, is slightly different, and they have a different kind of application. So we have basic inventory of both.
Okay.
So depending on the market, we just ramp up our production. That is the thing.
Okay. So of course, you know, it is nice to know that you have a product, right? Your products are already ready. You have the technology in-house, which your BMS thing and everything. So of course, there is another thing that is going to complete that trinity, and that is the political environment of ease of doing business right now in the country. So I just wanted to know from you, being one of the biggest firms in India right now, is the political environment in the country right now to do business particularly, is it good, is it favorable for you guys? Just tell me in the backdrop of demonetization a few, you know, in 2016 and then later GST. So of course there were news that a lot of industries did take a hit. They, you know, they were sort of, they had to stop businesses and they were plunged back 5 years, 10 years down the line, right? So do you think that currently, after for 2 years following demonetization and GST, do you think the political environment now is okay to do business in the country?
Yes, definitely. The environment has improved now, and the biggest benefit earlier, see, we were accounting for so many things, excise duty and this duty and that duty, and so many people were there. Now there is one GST, so, and it is completely moderatable basically, so you can adjust everything. So that becomes quite easy basically. So environment has eased out, first thing. Second, now they have standardized the rate. Earlier there were so many slabs, so it was very confusing. So now if you talk of our lithium batteries, government has put in 18% slab basically, sale tax slab. So now it is quite competitive, everybody is clear. So that way I see that it is quite easy now, basically, instead of filing so many returns earlier, so it becomes easy. For demonetization, see, there are different views basically, because if you talk of industry, then it is a very welcome step.
Okay.
But if you talk of retail, then definitely for some time there was a drop in that thing, retail business, because of this monetary confusion, shortage of cash and like that. But if you talk of industry, as such, industry has not felt much of this thing.
Okay.
Because most of the OEMs and they are well in this kind of thing. And earlier also they were doing all the transition through check or RTGS or like that only. So cash was not involved basically, if you see of the industry.
Big transactions.
Yeah, big transactions were there, and basically everything was monitored earlier also and now also. Now it has become more systematic because every month you have to file GST and all this thing. So retail definitely has taken some dent in between.
But you're saying that your particular business did not suffer much from, because I'm sure you were operational during demonetization GST board.
Definitely we were operational at that time also. And because most of our supplies are to OEMs basically. So they all are very well set companies basically.
Right.
So they don't deal in cash anywhere.
Right.
All tender business, all other business. So everywhere it is very clear.
Okay, Mr. Bhatnagar, since you're such a veteran in the industry now, so I think it is apt to ask you, and of course I'm sure that you get this question asked a lot by other journalists as well. How big of a threat do you think China is, if it is at all, you know, a threat still to the Indian market, especially talking special terms with the lithium industry? I mean, what is currently, you know, the scenario in our country, and are we still dependent on China, and how long will the dependence go on?
See, China and India, basically, see, there are some differences, basically. The biggest difference as of now is China has launched this electric vehicle some 4 or 5 years back.
Yes.
We are slightly new as far as India. We have started and some projects have come and like that. So that is one thing. Second is the stocks of raw material like lithium or if you talk of cobalt or other things. So China and other countries have these kind of reserves, like Argentina has this thing, Bolivia has. So these countries have these reserves. India basically have not done much of survey in this thing.
Okay.
So maybe reserves are there or not, we are not clear basically.
Okay. Okay.
So presently this is import. If we anybody puts a cell plant, so it is an import. That
the
is
raw first. Material is being imported?
Yeah, raw material, major of them, because lithium is not in India. Cobalt is also not there. So that you have to import.
Okay.
Right, that is one thing. Second is technology. Because European countries and China and Korea and all these countries, they have technology.
Yes.
So this is slightly complicated technology. So first time you have to go for some technology tie-ups with these giants.
That
kind of expertise you have to take basically. So once technology is there, then production is not a problem in India. Now comes your competition and other things. So I see India is very competitive that way. So imports is one factor. But world over you see the prices are driven in kilowatt hour. So everybody talks of a particular USD kilowatt hour. Like they will say, okay, this particular pack will cost you $300 per kilowatt hour. So that way India can manage well because here factories are good, manpower is available, other things are available, resources are there definitely. And our biggest plus point is that we have a huge consumption locally, domestic.
Yes, of course.
So whatever you do, you can sell locally. And internationally also you see we have a quite good rating outside. So exports from India are always welcome. So that is also a plus point with us. So I think overall, see, for time being you can say for some time, okay, all these countries can put some pressure. But in long term it is not there. Long term we will do very good.
So since you have now talked about the long term, I think it is apt to ask you now as to what your expectations are from Micromax in the long term. What do you envision in the future? Where do you see this company going forward? And what are your general expectations from the company?
Yeah. See, presently what we are doing, we are short of supplies always for the Indian market. So much of demand is there. And Micromax plus point is that we have very good after sales service setup. So a lot of people go for that because this is a very new field. So definitely some teething troubles are always there in your supplies. Some problem will be there, some BMS problem, some issue will be there. So if you have a proper after sales, so that is a big plus point. So there are two kind of people. One is basically importers. They will import and just sell. So they don't know how to do. If there is after sales problem, they don't know the product itself. But because we are making everything in-house, we know the BMS, we know the connections, we know the packing, we know what we have made. So after sales become quite easy. So that is one thing. Second, because it is a very growing market, and whether it is electric vehicles or solar or other things, I think 3-4 years, we are totally, basically whatever we make, we can supply easily in India. But if there is excess capacity, huge potential of export is available. All African countries, continent this side, and many places.
Africa is becoming a great market to export.
Africa is becoming a great market because same issues there also. Electricity problem and underdevelopment and all this. So huge demand is there for everywhere. And slowly and slowly people are shifting from lead acid to lithium. Because now people know that, okay, lead acid charging is an issue, pollution is an issue. So wherever it is required, people are shifting, especially in the critical application, lithium is going. So potential wise, I don't foresee any problem as such. And coming years are very good. Very good.
Okay. Thank you so much for talking to me, sir. Thank you. It was wonderful meeting you. Thank you.